And if you've never done the Sphinx before, imagine. It's much like the regal statue that you usually see with pyramids.
Regal?
Thanks. Yeah, they're in there. So just take a couple moments, close your eyes. Maybe slide your elbows slightly forward, ask her. So you can be a little bit more passive in the inhale. And with the first couple of postures, we're practicing yin yoga. So the idea is that it's the opposite of yang. You can imagine yang is the fire, the heat producing. Dynamic movement field. So the opposite is the water, the passive, the secret, the cooling. And instead of affecting the surface and our muscles, the yin affects more the tissues in our body that are moving towards bone, especially the ligaments and the tendons. Part of my body that actually takes longer to stretch, longer to wake up, moves a little bit more slowly. So feel how your physical body is doing this way. The part of your body that goes back to the earth after we die. And it's not a solid hunk of meat, but it's actually a dynamic system. In our perception, we don't notice the dance of molecules exchanging themselves between us and the tree and each other, the air, the earth, all around us. If we were aware on that level, we'd probably be dizzy because there's so much activity going on. And it's actually like a gift to us that our sense perception doesn't notice that yet. So feel your bones a little heavier. And take 10 more full deep breaths. After your 10th breath, just relax down to the ground. If you lost count, you just wait for someone else to do it first. And don't be humiliated that you can't count to 10 this morning. But just notice. wiggle your hips side to side. Maybe moan a little bit. This is oddly part of the processing of feelings and what comes up in the yin pose. We can release it with movement and sound. So if you're feeling it a little shy, let's join together. Take a big inhale and just motor go. Beautifully again. And then bring your hands underneath your shoulders. Push yourselves back to your heels. Cross your ankles and roll over your cross ankle and come into butterfly. You want about 2 hands length between your heel and your groin. Long. And if you're not sure, just move your feet a little further away. You're actually basically trying to measure from where you fold at your hips to your head. Because this cool thing happens, you have this nice little pillow for where your head falls. Who knew, right? Lift up tall. And tuck your chin
and roll down.
So you might be rolling down really deeply till your chin hits your chest-ish. Or maybe you are comfortably relaxing your forehead onto your feet. But you want to find the place in between. Most of us are kind of in this awkward stage in between not being able to bend and being comfortable lying down cradled by your instep. So on purpose, allow your body to relax and become still. And just as we pay attention to our physical body, the stuff of our body, take your next couple of breaths to notice, even in the stillness, how much energy is in your body. Relax your hands. Relax your tongue. Feel your head heavy. So you can imagine the energy of your body is the precursor to your physical shape. The guide that your physical body knows to shape itself around. Much like how ice forms over a branch. Notice if you can feel places where your energy is a little duller or quieter, and where it's louder. Notice perhaps that when you bring your attention to a certain part of your body, you can actually feel the effects of the energy of your attention warming up and enlivening that part of your body. It's a good practice in realizing that our attention brings life. And that's true not just in our bodies, but everywhere. Now see if you can count quietly to yourself 10 more full deep breaths. And after your 10th breath, just roll up your upper body. If you lost count, some people look like they've come to 10. Feel free to pretend that you've come to 10. Moan and groan is fine. You can also do the eyebrow thing. But I think the moaning really helps more. And then bring your hands back behind you and lift up your chest. You're actually your elbows. Lift up your chest and then your head drop back. If that aggravates your neck, you can bring your chin to your chest. Maybe relax your jaw a little bit more. And then let your upper body relax all the way down to the ground. Bring your hand to your heart, bring your hand to your belly, leaving your feet as they are. I know, annoying. And probably closing your eyes when the lights are still on. Just take a couple moments and notice how you're feeling this morning. How your mood is. How your attitude is. You can imagine our emotions like a membrane or a filter that we act through and receive through. You can imagine if you're pissed off, what someone has to say will land very differently than if you're feeling joyful. Or if you're worried how you will come across in what you say differently than if you are scared or happy. And with our mood and our attitude, we have a chance and some influence in shaping our feelings. Hug your knees to your chest. Lift up your face and kiss your knees. Good morning. Embrace your opportunity to enjoy this earthly embodiment. And start to roll back and forth in your spine and see if you can get enough momentum to come up onto your feet to a forward bend without your hands touching the ground
before you bend over.
Take a big inhale, the exhale, just side up. Take a couple moments to notice how your thinking is this morning. So sometimes we wake up in the morning and we're thinking. And other times it takes a little while to slowly kind of wake up and thinking. And then take an inhale, with your exhale, try to sound like a horse. So you're kind of go. And just notice what you'll do, just meditation. But like, well, shake out your head, relax your face. And then push down with your feet and roll all the way up to the sky, reach up top. Look up, maybe grin at the ceiling. And ask for the help that you want quietly to yourself in supporting you in your day. With your exhale, bring your hands to heart center. Let your elbows drop. Stand your feet together. Close your eyes and we're going to own. So let your elbows be heavy. Yeah, the emphasis is more the connection of your hands to your chest. We're gonna do three ohms, and sometimes they sound delightful, and other times they sound curiously weird. And whatever they sound like this morning, just go with it. See if you can hear everybody else's voice. So empty your breath, close your eyes, or look at your fingertips. Take a deep inhale. And if you're not sure, make one up. And feel into it. And if you peek, that's fine, but then close your eyes and feel it. Like, it must be awesome to be a hero. To feel like a hero. Are you holding back? You don't have to hold back. And then make your way to the top of the mat. Stretch your arms up high. With your exhale, bow over. Inhale, halfway lift. And then step back to plank. And slowly exhale all the way down to the ground. Inhale, low cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. So if you're not sure, you're kind of making them up, perfect. Take another full inhale. Empty your breath all the way. And then walk your feet in between your hands. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, release and bow down. Push down with your feet, rise up tall, reach up for the sky. And exhale, Samasthiti. Let your mouth lift a little bit. Inhale, stretch your arms up high. Exhale, bow forward. Inhale, halfway lift. Walk or float. This time, exhale, halfway down, Chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Now, look at your hands. You want to have your fingers spread out and your middle fingers essentially pointing straight forward like they're an extension of your forearms. As you relax your gaze back, you're looking in between your feet. You can walk your hands a little bit more forward. Take another full inhale. Exhale, breath all the way. And then walk or jump your feet in between your hands. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, release the back down and pendulum. Push down with your feet and rise up tall, lift up high. And exhale, Samasthiti Ki. Bring your hands to prayer and let them relax at the end of your inhale. Exhale. And then raise your arms back up for the inhale. Exhale, bow forward, feel the surrender in the bow. Inhale, feel the activity of the lift. Halfway lift. And then step back to plank, lower halfway down, Chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. So if you're just starting out, awesome, make stuff up, copy everyone else. And for all of us, make your mistakes like you mean them. You can actually move through class and kind of mess up everything, and you'll still feel better, and you're still allowed back. Inhale, stretch your right leg up to the sky. And then bend your knee and let your hips spin open. Allow yourself to breathe. Maybe try to keep your own butt. We want to be skilled here. Yes. Let your left heel drop down behind your left toes. And with your exhale, bring your knee, you're going ahead of me, that's perfect. With your exhale, bring your knee to your nose. Sniff your knee, push your weight forward, pull your belly up to your spine. And then inhale, stretch your right leg long. Exhale, relax your right leg down. So we're going to do the same thing on the other side. Inhale, stretch your left leg long. Bend your knee, let your hips spin over. Your heels drop to the ground behind your right toes. So your right foot. Okay.
long. Exhale, walk your feet in between your hands. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, release the bow down, let your head drop. Push down your feet. Inhale, up to the sky, reach up top. Exhale, bring your hands through some seats deep. Let them relax by your side. And bend your knees, drop your booty. Inhale, Utkatasana. Especially if you had a crazy dance class yesterday, just go low, like juice it. Let your thighs be like burning, really some flames coming up off of them. Step your feet together and get a little bit more power from the earth. Stretch your arms out, then you don't have to carry any like limp things. Maybe smile a little bit to make more friends with your posture. Sink your hips. Take another full inhale. And with your exhale, bow forward. Inhale, halfway lift. Walk or float. Exhale, chuck the right foot over the ground. Inhale, upward facing dog or low cobra. Point your toes. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, stretch your right leg up to the sky. And with your exhale, step your right foot all the way forward to your right thumb. Let your left heel spin to the ground and then feel the strength of your legs as you reach up and come into warrior one. Feel your left heel down, pushing up to the ground, and you're pushing the outside edge of your foot to the ground. Let your hands be expressive. Lunge a little deeper. Take another full inhale, maybe up into the back end, and then exhale all the way down to Chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog, allowing your heart to come in front of your shoulders. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, stretch your left leg up to the sky. Exhale, step your left foot all the way to your left thumb, even if you can help it. And then spin your right foot to the ground and raise up, warrior one. Now, take your hands to your hips. And look at your beautiful right foot. And you want to see that your knee and your foot are pointing in the same direction, pretty much always. Yeah? And then spin your hips forward. And if your hips won't go, step your right foot more to the right. And you create the space for your hips to be pointing straight forward. Both of them. So move your right foot more to the right. Let your toes spin around. Yeah.
Yes.
And then from there, find the lightness in your upper body. Just stretch your arms all the way up, like you're growing your nails longer. Yoga is really good for your hair and your nails. It's awesome. Take another full inhale. And then follow your breath all the way down. Chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward. Spread out your fingers, take a big inhale with your exhale, just sigh it out. Feel your connection to the earth to find the lightness that you have to lift away from it. Take another full inhale. Empty your breath all the way. Walk or float your feet forward. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, release and bow down. Bend your knees, drop your booty. Inhale, move. It's awesome. Exhale, stop the inhale, move. Utkatasana. Exhale, open up, twist to your right. Inhale, up to center. Exhale, open up, twist to your left. Inhale up to center. Exhale, bow forward. Inhale, halfway lift. Walk or float. Exhale, chuck that down foot or the ground. Inhale, upward facing dog or low cobra. Lift your thighs. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, stretch your right leg long. Exhale, bring your right knee to touch your left elbow. Inhale, stretch right leg long. your right thumb, rise up, warrior one, one breath, right where you were, exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, stretch your left leg up to the sky. Exhale, bring it across your body, touch your right elbow. Inhale, stretch your leg long. Exhale, step your foot all the way forward. Rise up, warrior one. Exhale, chaturanga, rise your breath. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Take another full inhale, side of your breath. So what would you correct if I came and walked right next to you? Take another full inhale. Empty your breath all the way. Look forward and see if you can float your feet in between your hands. Looking more forward. Yes. Nice. When you first do it, you feel like you're going to go all the way to the wall. That's perfect. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, release them now down. Bend your knees deeply. Drop the inch on the open side. Exhale, open up, twist your neck. Inhale up to center. Exhale, open up, twist to your left. Inhale up to center. Exhale, sun seat. Take it low. Inhale, open top. Exhale, open up, twist to your right. Inhale up to center. Exhale, open up, twist to your left. Inhale up to center. Exhale, bow forward. Inhale, halfway lift. Fly or float.
Colors, the whole experience.
Awesome. And then walk your feet in between your hands. Separate your feet hip distance apart. Lift up your gorgeous toes and slide your hands underneath your feet. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, release and drop your head. So separate your feet more or less. Why would you step on your hands? But it's actually a wrist release. Separate your feet a little bit more, step. And your toes should be touching that wonderful little bracelet. Awesome. So you're flirting with the edge here. You want to be such that you might nearly fall over. Outside of your right knee, and lovingly pull your left knee back a little bit. Now drop your hips so low while you're still in a twist that your heels lift up and you can release your right hand down to the ground. Your left elbow still is sticking to your right knee. Then turn your fingertips to your right. And if you're just beginning in this posture, you're welcome to bring your right elbow to your right hip. And then you bend your arms, and they're pretty much just like an arm rest. And you can rest on them by bringing the weight to your fingertips. And if you're going to fall, it's really cool. The ground's really close by. Beautiful, Steph. Lift up your head. And like, the attitude of what you think makes such a difference.
I know.
Okay, whether you fell on your butt or your face, hopefully not too hard, come back as you can back to.
Ooh, good stuff. Ooh, yeah.
And with your exhale, bring your hands to heart center. Twist to your left. Right elbow hooks to the outside of your left knee. Let your shoulders come down. And you want your butt lower than your heart, just general rule. In life, be grounded and happy, right? And then let your heels lift up, and you keep your right elbow glued to your left knee there. And as a training wheel, you bring your left elbow in. You have your hands about shoulder distance apart. Spread out your fingers, and then make chaturanga arms, which is like a little armrest. Clearly, that's where the name came from. And if it's easy for you, Ollie.
It's not easy.
That was nice. You're welcome to stretch your legs straight.
Or am I?
Both of them. Same time, I know. Love you. So you want to play with the edge. Like, where do you start to be like, oh, nice. And then come back, find your way back to, oh, God, awesome. And with your exhale, bow forward. Inhale, halfway lift, separate your feet hip distance apart, and squat down into goddess pose. Goddess pose. I love goddesses too. Totally. Now lift up your chest. So instead of like the crone, we're going for like a really hot mama. I mean, like the source of food, like that's amazing, right? I don't want to talk about it that much. And then we're going to plant your hands on the ground. And if you've never lifted up a crow before, take your hands a little wider. And you're going to bring your knees to the back of your arms. And then bring your weight towards your fingertips. And lift up your feet. Maybe one foot today. some, we don't all learn things the same way. Okay, what I'm saying? So maybe it'll be easier for you if you actually bring your head down to the ground and you lift up your knees to your elbows. And then you can clap. But then you might be able to lift up. Go ahead. It's not easier for me, as you can tell. But try it out. So you plant your hands, bring your head down. You can see your fingernails. Oh, nice clapping, Aurora. If it's easy, feel free to stretch your legs straight up to the sky into headstand. But you want to see your fingernails, don't you? They're right at the top of your fingers. Squeeze your elbows together. Nice step. And then come back, bring your knees to your arms, and maybe lift up into crow, and shoot back chaturanga. Or you can go straight to chaturanga ollie if you want. And you kind of make it to your make it. It was just an option. So let's do that in chaturanga. Inhale, outward facing dog. Oh, that should feel so good now. Open your heart, open your chest. Exhale, downward facing dog. Take a full inhale, pull your hips up and back. And with your exhale, float your feet all the way through your hands into monster butt. It's halfway there. Monster butt. Chest arching up, and then slowly, one vertebrae at a time, roll down. Take a big inhale, your exhale, just sigh out. Inhale, lift your hips. Now you might feel a little bit more. Our vinyasa really does bring some fire into the body. So maybe you're ready to bring your hands up next to your ears, fingers pointing down to your heels, and inhale first just to the top of your head. Then squeeze your elbows together, slide your shoulders down towards your butt. And then inhale, lift up. Try to push your hips up to the ceiling. Push. Spin your toes in crystal, darling. Beautiful. And then slowly bring your chin to your chest and roll down. Stretch your legs long. Bring one hand to your heart, one hand to your belly. You can do a little wrist roll in between. When we first start our vinyasa, the wrists bear a lot more weight than they're used to. And so you feel it. But really, it's the muscle building up in the beginning. And especially for women,
the vinyasa is really important because it builds up our upper body strength more than some other practices do. And women tend to be really strong in their legs and thighs and not so much in their upper body. And so they really want to work on balancing their strength with their upper body. And with men, it's typically the other way around, that they tend to be strong up here, but not so much in their legs. So in the practice, you really want to focus on what you need to balance your strength. Then bring the bottoms of your feet together. Let your knees fall open and Supta Baddha Konasana. Feel the hip opening. Then hug your knees to your chest. If you feel shy earlier when you sneak in a kiss, feel free to kiss your knees in the morning. It's amazing how much your body takes you through. And then open up your arms and slowly drop your knees to your left, keeping your knees higher than your hips. Take a full inhale, and for exhale, let it move through your mouth. Maybe it's a sigh, maybe it's a moan. So in our practice, the yin and yang together, we move our physical body because of our energy. But you notice that that also moves your emotion, your mood, your attitude. Both from the motion of your body and the thinking of your mind. This being human is like a creativity toolbox. It's amazing that we can use our mind to change our feelings or to move our body. Or we can move our body that will increase our energy to liberate our thinking. This dynamic relationship allows for your authorship, for what you want to script into your life. Hug your knees back to center. And drop the knees slowly to the right hand side. And then find your way back to center and make yourself ready for shavasana. Making sure you stay warm. Stretching your legs long. Palms open to the ceiling. Let the floor hold you. Let your attention stay in your body. Invite your breath to the edges of your body. Wiggle your fingers, your toes, your nose. And then roll onto the right-hand side of yourself, hugging your knees to your chest. And just take a moment to feel the vibrancy in your body. And maybe to think of something that allows you to feel grateful and filled with joy. Remind yourself, whatever that is, you're incredible. And then help yourself up into a comfortable seated position. Allow your hands to meet at heart center. Feel the earth below you so you can stretch up tall above it. Empty your breath. Take a deep inhale. Thank you guys. It's great to have you all here this morning.